I was trying to find some information.
Oh, what am I now, one of your suspects?
When you act like one, are you on anything?
Oh, for God's sake.
Don't use that tone with me, Allie.
How are you, Mr. Chris?
Very good, sir, thanks.
When I first saw Remember, or when I first was going to see it, I was like, Chris Cooper in a love story? Because I had no idea what the movie is about.
Sure, yeah.
But then I saw it, and I broke my heart.
Well, good.
I understand now why you made the film.
Well, I love working in New York, and it always seems to be a character of its own in a film. It's a lovely script. Takes a good strong look at young love and some tragic loss with different individuals in the film. And so it's just a good, full story.
I smell alcohol.
Yeah, so do I.
What's going on here, Allie? You trying to tell me something with this? You all grown up now?
You know, maybe it's time you get used to it, Dad, before you give yourself a heart attack.
He's a cop, and he deals with the worst that the city can give him every day. And he has lost his wife by some of the very people that he deals with
every
day. So Allie, his daughter, and he have lost their mother through a tragic incident, and they're very dependent on each other over the years, and for lack of better words, it is kind of a marriage, and he is very protective of his daughter, and life has not been too kind to either of them. So I think there's a strong reaction when this young man comes along, and they have a relationship, and we find out that this twist of fate that brought these youngsters together, I had something to do with, and there's an idea of revenge in this coupling. So it's an interesting twist.
Turn on the meter.
Never, so. So dessert first. The fear of asteroid, yes. But, kissing a guy you seem to be attracted to, at least before driving off into the unknown.
The theme through the film for me involves loss.
And love. Love and loss.
Love and loss. And I don't think the people that are still around want to forget those that have been.
So you just went to the Philippines?
I did, yeah.
What were you doing there?
I was working for the fifth time with my good friend John Sayles, and dealt with a piece of history that we, again, Americans know virtually nothing about, and it was the American occupation of the Philippines at the turn of the century.
Right.
So we have a bunch of new, young actors playing some of the soldiers, and we have some great Filipino talent. So they're still in the middle of shooting that film. I got back about 4 or 5 days ago.
What's the working title of the film?
It's called Barrio, B-A-R-Y-O.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
From my home country.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr.
Thank you.
And good luck.
Thank you, sir.
Someone's been trying to tell me something. Make her yours forever. No marking on the forever part.